If you want to learn how to set up and host a live event, then keep on watching. Hi, my name is Tony, and this is my channel, Ready Steady XL. If you want to learn more about these applications, then by clicking subscribe and hitting the bell, we'll put you on the right track. Live events allows you to host an event for up to 10,000 people. Now, this might be more than you will ever need, but the great thing about live events, it allows you to easily manage the content and the videos. You can also invite others to help you present and produce the event. Now, one of the drawbacks with live events is that all your attendees will be muted and there isn't an option to unmute them. However, there is a chat and Q&A function so they can still interact with you. Okay, are you ready? Then let's go. So let's start by setting up our live event. So to do that, we go to calendar and then up here at the top right, we click on live events. On the left-hand side, you've got all the fields that you might expect for setting up an event. So you've got things like the title, location, dates, and times. And on the right-hand side is where you start inviting or where you can invite producers and presenters to help you out with this live event. First, let's just set up the event itself. So on the right-hand side, this is where we can start adding people to help us out with this event. So you have two options. You've got a producer, and the producer has these responsibilities. And then the other option is a presenter. Okay. So as a presenter, the idea is that you upload your content, put on your video, and then the producer chooses when this goes to live, when the attendees can see this, and when to start the event. Today, I'm a one-man show, so I'm just going to keep myself as the producer. And if I click next. Okay, live event permissions. You've got three options here. The first option is a bit more private. So for this one, only people that have been invited can join this live event. You've got org-wide, so only people within your organization. So people with the same email address. And then public, anyone can access. For this example, I'm gonna go for org-wide. How will you produce your live event? So you've got a number of options here. Recording, the live event automatically records when you press start. But do you want the attendees to have access to that report? The report is available for 180 days, so 6 months after the live event. I'm gonna keep that one switched on. Next up is captions. Captions are like subtitles, so automatically they will appear under the screen. Now the attendees will have the choice to switch those off too if they want to. There's also an option there to translate it. So it translates up to 6 languages, which is pretty whizzy. Next up is the attendee engagement report. So this is like an attendance report really. It will show who has joined the meeting, when they left. It also shows their email addresses, so if you want to get back in contact. So Q&A, so this is what sets live events apart from meetings. Because with a Q&A, it works like a chat, but it's a bit more controlled because you can choose when to switch it on or switch it off during the meeting. So if you don't want to be bombarded during your live event with questions and responses, you can choose to switch off a Q&A, and this is during your live event. Also, when the messages come in, they will come in as private to you or the other presenters and producers you might have added to this event. So it comes in private to you, and then you can choose whether to publish those questions or responses to the rest of the live events or all the other attendees. This area allows you to stream from an external encoder like Open Broadcast Software or OBS. We're not going to use this in today's video. And then scrolling down, we've got support. And with this one, this is where you can put in a link to like your local IT if you've got any issues, or maybe your audio and visual team, the AV team. So I'm going to keep that one as it is. That will go to the Microsoft Office page. And I'm going to click schedule. Now you might have noticed during the setup of this, I never invited anyone. So I didn't invite any other attendees. So when you set up these events, how it works is that you get the attendee link. And what you do with this, you click on it, it copies it, and then you paste it in to a calendar appointment in Outlook. And that's when you can just send it off to the attendees. Okay, so that's our meeting all set. You do have the option to edit and then go back into it if you needed to go back through those steps, but I'm just gonna click close. Just to show you what's happened here, we've got the event in there, which is great. And how you know it's an event, not a normal standard meeting, is that you've got this sort of radio mask tower in the bottom right-hand corner here. So that's how you know it's a live event. Okay, so let's join our live event. Now, it's recommended that you join your live event 30 minutes before the start time, and this just allows you to get set up and ensure that everything is working. So let's go in. So I'm just going to click once, click here to join. Just to point out, you will notice that you don't have the change background option that you have in your standard Microsoft Teams meeting. So I can't change the background here. You might have seen one of my earlier videos on how to change the virtual background. So you don't have that option as a producer. If I was logged in as a presenter, then I would have that option. But for some reason, at the moment, at the time of this recording, producers can't change their background, which is a shame. Let's join now. So this is the producer screen. So what we have, we've got three main areas really. Down here at the bottom, we've got the content area. Then we've got the queue. So this is where the content will sit before it goes to live. Now at the moment, we're not live. It says pre-live up here. We don't go live until we press start. Okay, so let's have a look at loading some content now. So I'm going to click on share. So this is where you can start sharing either a window, an application, or you can share your whole desktop. Now, if you're going to share a presentation, what I recommend is that you go to your presentation and then launch it first. So I'm just going to click here, start the presentation. And then if I go back to Teams and then share again, I've got my presentation there. So the presentation will be done as a full screen rather than the application itself. So if I just tap on this, I get a message here from MS Teams. So I just tap here and this will bring me back to my producer window. So there's my content. So if I tap again, so that's in the queue. If I want to put it to the live event, I just press send live and there it is there. But we haven't gone live yet. It doesn't go live until we press start. Okay, so the broadcast hasn't started yet. It allows me to just to get my content ready. So I'm gonna put my video on. So I might wanna switch to my video at some point. So I'll tap there once, there I am. And like I said, at any point when I wanna put this to the attendees, I just press send live. Now, another thing that you might want to do is you might want to have your video and your presentation side by side. So you can do that, and to do that, you go here. So it's this icon, there's my video there. And if I click on the content again, I can have the two running side by side. Okay, so let's just do send live. There it is there. So once you're ready to go live, you just simply press start, and then read this message very carefully. Once you start, you can't stop and restart. That sounds like me on the dance floor. The event can last up to 16 hours from the start time, and attendees will watch at a 10 to 20 second delay. So there's a slight delay between what you're presenting and what the attendees get. I'm gonna press continue and I get a warning that my mic's unmuted, which is fine. So now I'm live, and I know I'm live because I've got this red box and up here it says live. Also, another thing to point out is that the session's recording. So this dot here has turned to red. So the session records automatically and this is downloadable at the end. And the idea is I can switch here to my presentation. I can click through my presentation and this is what my attendees will see. So let's go back to Teams. So I'm pressing Alt Tab there. So let's look at some of the other options you've got available. So up here, you've got like a health check. So you can check how the system's running. This is a Q&A function that I was telling you about. So here, new messages will come into new. You've got the option here to switch it on or off during your meeting. So if you don't want to be distracted or just have it more controlled. If you want to fire off a question, then you can, then everyone will get that message. And any replies will come in as private unless I click publish. Now it's worth noting with live events is that your audience is muted, okay, automatically. You won't be able to unmute them. So just remember that your public, your attendees, won't be able to answer back, okay? So they can only use this Q&A feature. There is a chat option here as well. It's better to get people to use the Q&A feature rather than the chat room. Just makes it easier to manage. So let's have a look at the other options we've got here. So we've got meeting note. I haven't used this myself, but it allows you to create notes, live notes during the session itself. And these would be available at the end. You've got the chat function that I've already mentioned. So this is the chat function, so you can send a message the whole event, but again, I prefer to use the Q&A. So this option here will show you a list of all the participants. So you'd have the long list here, and if you want to invite anyone else, then it's just a matter of completing that field. Next up, you've got your settings in regards to your audio and visual. So the last option here is the invite details. Okay, so once you've come to the end of your live event, you will then just click end. Again, just read this message very carefully. Once you end it, you can't restart the event. So I'm gonna say end it. And then up here it says ended as well, and then you can safely leave. Now at the end of the meeting, you've got a list of available resources for you. So let's have a look at those now. So if I go into the calendar appointment, down here I've got live event resources. There are various resources that you can download after the event. So you can download a recording, which is available for 180 days after the event. You can download an attendance report, which also includes their email addresses where provided. And you've also got a Q&A report, which logs any questions that were raised during the session. This too will include the email addresses where provided. This is the video that I want you to watch next. And this is the video that YouTube wants you to watch next. And if you haven't already, then please click subscribe. I will see you in the next video.